No, there's a question that people often ask themselves, and probably you've had conversations with people on this, about do dreams come true or is it all written in our destiny? If you personally ask me this question, I may not have a very spiritually or scientifically convincing answer, but all I can share with you is a little story from my own life. And get you to reflect what's true for you, because some people say with a lot of conviction that dreams do come true. Some people say it's your destiny and whatever is in your destiny, it comes true. I've still not been able to establish my theory on this, but I wanted to put out my thoughts and probably get your inputs to understand how you view this. Is it about dreaming and believing that that dream will come true? Or is it about surrendering yourself to the universe and saying, give me what is in the highest of my destiny? Well, the reason I'm doing this video, or I'm starting this conversation with all of you, is because I'm approaching a very, very special milestone in my own life as an entrepreneur. In the month of January 2021, I'm going to be doing my 50th PACE program. And for those of you who've been following my work, you would know that the Business PACE program is my 3-day signature program where I help entrepreneurs with a step-by-step system to set goals, track goals, and achieve goals in their life. So what I wanted to share with all of you today was the journey of how PACE actually started. How did this system actually get created? And today, where it has reached. And through this conversation, I want to reflect whether this was a dream come true or was this in my destiny. So let me give you a little backstory. I started my journey as an entrepreneur in the year 2006. I set up my training company, Quantum Leap Learning Solutions Private Limited. For the first 10 years, we focused on corporate training itself. And corporate training in India is not a very rewarding profession, purely because somewhere you can say the supply of the number of trainers is too many and there's no real differentiator. So corporates also take advantage of that and they treat it like a commodity, and trainers in India get paid as low as 10,000, 15,000, 20,000 rupees for one day of training, which in comparison to any other country on the planet, even our neighbors like Sri Lanka or Bangladesh or Singapore or any other country even across Southeast Asia, is very, very low. So for me, for the first 10 years as an entrepreneur, I was very passionate about training. I loved standing on stage. I loved teaching people. I loved seeing people go through their transformation. So this business gave me a lot of job satisfaction. It did not give me job satisfaction. As a training company, we would be stuck in the range of 60 to 80 lakhs per annum as a turnover. And you must be wondering, 60 to 80 lakhs per annum is good money as a trainer. Well, if you are an individual trainer, it's great money. But we were a corporate training company. Karan, Pranav and I were business partners. We had a 2-member sales team who would go to corporates and get business for us. We had a 2-member telemarketing team who would set appointments. We had 4 trainers full-time working with us on our payroll. We had a content developer. We had an admin team, an accounts person. And with a payroll like that, 60 to 80 lakhs per annum is nothing. And as entrepreneurs, we always thought there will be a tipping point, something will work out, our work will get recognized, and we were just going with the flow. It was not an easy phase at all. We wouldn't pay ourselves consistently. We would not take salaries for ourselves. There were no profits to be shared, but we would do it with a lot of passion. And sometimes you would question, why are you doing this? Some of you must be wondering, I'm sharing with you your story. Where you are working really hard, you're talented, your work is appreciated, but you're not able to achieve the financial goals that you aspire to achieve. So that was our story pretty much for the first 10 years from 2006 to 2016. The journey of PACE actually started in the year 2013. In 2013, I got a call from one of India's largest accounting software companies saying, we want you to give us a proposal for a sales training, for a key account management training, and for a communication training for our sales team. I'll be honest, and I haven't shared this till date, I didn't understand what is key account management. So I went and Googled key account management, and Google gave me a definition saying it's about handling key relationships with your dealers or distributors or your critical channel partners or your critical suppliers. And I had no idea, how do I submit a learning proposal? So I did what every entrepreneur does. When you have no idea, you ask another question. So I told this organization that, hey, listen, I don't just submit a learning proposal or a learning plan of what we will teach in the training program. Before submitting what are the topics we'll cover in these trainings, I would like to do an interview, a research-based interview with the people you want us to train, with the managers of the people you want us to train, and with all the other related stakeholders who work with the people you want us to train, to really understand what's the deeper objective of this training. They loved the idea because I offered it for free, and they said, okay, come over, we'll set up interviews for you. And I went in, and it was a sales team, so I met a few of the salespeople as a sample size. I started asking them questions about what do they do on a day-to-day basis in their job role, what are the challenges that they face. What I realized was this sales team's responsibility was actually to manage the dealers and distributors of this accounting software company. And the challenge they were facing was that every month when they went to their dealers and distributors saying that, hey, you need to increase the sales, the dealers and distributors kind of resisted and gave a very strong pushback to them saying, don't come and tell me that I need to set a target. My business has its own challenges, and you as a company are only bothered about pushing your product. So I don't care about what you have to say about my targets. So their bigger challenge was actually the resistance that they had with these dealers and distributors. So the real problem that the company was trying to solve was, how do you bridge or how do you refresh that relationship between the sales team and the dealers and distributors? How do you renew that relationship? Because the relationship had hit a fatigue. Every month the same thing, every month squabbling on targets and every month not hitting targets. That was like the standard way of relating to each other. So that made me curious, and I said, hey, I'd like to interview the dealers and distributors. So I went and interviewed the dealers and distributors. And till that point, I was only working with large corporate organizations. For the first 10 years as a trainer, I was just focusing on corporate organizations. So this was the first time I was talking to small and medium business owners. Your typical, like their dealers and distributors range from smaller IT companies who integrated their accounting software and built technologies on it and sold it, to retail shop owners selling computer hardware, and they would stock this software product as well and sell it there, to service technicians of laptops and computers who were registered as dealers for this accounting software. So this was the first time I was talking to SME owners, retailers, individual service professionals, to understand, why do they behave the way they behave? Why are they not focused on sales? Why are they undercutting the price and selling the accounting software? And why are they spoiling the market for themselves? And when I started doing these interviews, in each one of these interviews, I found myself. I was like, hey, all their challenges are the exact challenges that I face as an entrepreneur. These guys set goals exactly like the way I set goals in my business, and these guys don't achieve it. These guys have people problems. They're not able to hire the right people. They're not able to find the right people, or they're not able to retain the people that they've hired and developed. These guys are not having any idea about how to generate new inquiries. They're just depending on word of mouth. And when I was hearing their challenges, I could empathize and relate to them quite a bit, because that was me as an entrepreneur for those first 8-9 years. That was me, where I would set goals, work really hard, do my team's work myself, not be able to retain people, not be able to market and get new customers or get more customers. I said, hey, this is me. And then a thought came. I said, look, for the company to expect these dealers and distributors to focus on product sales when they are drowning in their own business challenges is an unrealistic expectation. So if a sales team member from this company is going every month and telling दीज डीलर्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स, आपका टारगेट क्या है, आप कितना अचीव करोगे, हमारा ये स्कीम है, हमारा ये प्लान है. ऑब्वियसली दैट एंटरप्रेन्योर वुड अब्यूज द सेल्स गाय एंड से गेट आउट ऑफ हियर, यू एंड योर कंपनी आर ओनली बॉदर्ड अबाउट योरसेल्फ. सो आई टुक दीज फाइंडिंग्स एंड आई वेंट बैक टू द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ दिस अकाउंटिंग सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनी. एंड लकीली फॉर मी, दिस वॉज अ वेरी वेरी विजनरी मैनेजमेंट. दे वर विलिंग टू अक्नॉलेज the reality on the ground. They said, hey, yes, we agree that the real challenge is that the dealers and distributors don't know how to generate customers, don't know how to generate inquiries, don't know how to retain people, don't know how to hire the right people, don't know how to set proper goals in their business. So they said, we love the findings of your approach. What do you think is the solution? I said, give me some time, let me reflect on this and come back. And then I came back and I asked myself a question. What creates results in business? What makes a business achieve their goals? And at that point of time, the thought that came to my head was, only when you have an entrepreneur who has capability, who has knowledge and skills, who is aware of strategies and systems to achieve their goals, can they achieve their business goals. And if an entrepreneur is not capable enough, does not have the required skills, does not have the required knowledge, it's very normal for that entrepreneur to work really hard, be good at what they do, but not if they're not good at the business side, then obviously the business is not going to achieve goals. So at that point of time, I just wrote these words down. Performance acceleration is a result of capability enhancement. So I just wrote and I was just staring at my notebook and I said, yeah, this makes sense that if you want to accelerate the performance of your business, you need to enhance your own capabilities. And a lot of entrepreneurs, they are good at what they do. A photographer is good at photography. An interior designer is good at interior design. A doctor is good at taking care of patients. A trainer is good at training. A manufacturer is good at manufacturing. They're good at what they do, but they don't have capabilities on the management side, the marketing side, the business model side. And I said, hey, this is so true. I'm a very good trainer myself, but I don't have skills on management, on marketing, on structuring the right business model myself. So I said, performance acceleration is a result of capability enhancement. Unless I don't enhance my capability in these areas, I cannot fulfill my own potential. I cannot achieve the goals of my business. So I went back to this organization and I said, firstly, as the sales team, we need to stop selling to the dealers and distributors. We need to start enabling the dealers and distributors, and we need to start helping them in setting goals which are holistic, helping them in designing an approach to achieve those goals, helping them in hiring the right people, helping them in training their team members, helping them in managing and leading those team members in the right way. So we need to really help the entrepreneur grow their capabilities so that they can grow their business. And when their business is growing and we as a company are adding value to this channel of dealers and distributors to help them grow their business, then their loyalty, then their relationship, then their responsiveness to the targets that the company wants them to set and achieve for selling the company's product will also grow. And again, I must say that it was divinity that this management was absolutely committed to their channel partners, and they said, you know what? It's easy for us to think, what's in it for us? Why should we put in the effort and grow the capability of these entrepreneurs when they are selling not just our product, but 100 other products in the market? But I think if we do it, we will have an edge. And they said, Rajiv, we are with you in this approach. Design an entire intervention plan. I said, this cannot be a one-day, two-day training. This has to be a process where we firstly need to change the role of our sales team. They cannot be called sales team. They have to be called partner growth catalysts. So we actually changed the role document of all the sales team members and we made them partner growth catalysts. We said, your job is to help the partner grow their business. So you are like a coach, you're like a catalyst. And I designed a step-by-step approach of setting holistic goals. Okay, of building capabilities in critical areas like management, marketing, and business model design, broke it into tasks that these guys could do on a weekly basis. And we had a system where I would train the so-called sales team, now the partner growth catalyst, on a weekly basis. They would go out there and pass the knowledge to their distributors, who would go out and pass the knowledge to their dealers. And as a result of that, in that focus group of dealers and distributors that we started implementing the system PACE, because PACE stood for performance acceleration as a result of capability enhancement at that point of time. So when we started implementing the system, they saw crazy levels of engagement, more ownership from their dealers and distributors, more seamless experience in building their own businesses as dealers and distributors, and they started achieving their goals. So that was the first version of PACE that got created in 2013. And for me, it felt very fulfilling because I was helping entrepreneurs like myself. And I started building on this philosophy of PACE for my own business. I started looking at what are the areas I need to grow in my capability. So I went and started learning marketing. I learned business model design. I learned more about management. And my way of learning was not just to read books, but I would interview entrepreneurs. So in 2014, I decided to author a book. I announced the book. I went out there. I interviewed 300 entrepreneurs from all across India. People like Kiran Mazumdar Shah, who's built Biocon, Ashok Soota, who's built Happiest Minds Technology, C.K. Kumaravel, who's built Natural Salon, Nina Lekhi, who built Bagit as a brand, Mukesh Punmiya, who built Invision from scratch, Gaurav and Siddharth, who built Wildcraft. I went on an interviewing journey to understand two things. What's the psychology required to build a scalable business? What is the systems and strategies required to build a scalable business? And when I was interviewing these entrepreneurs, I was trying to validate my theory of PACE. Is performance acceleration a result of capability or what I would call competence enhancement? And as I was interviewing, you know, Brian Tracy has this quote that says success has a pattern. If you do what successful people do, you get what successful people have. If you do what mediocre people do, you get what mediocre people have. And I started seeing, irrespective of the industries of these 300 leaders that I was interviewing, their way of thinking, their way of growing their business was very, very similar. So success had a pattern, which made me more curious. And through those interviews, I started realizing that one aspect is capability enhancement. The other aspect is also clarity. Most entrepreneurs don't have clarity of their own business. They don't know how to set goals. They just set a financial target and they call it a goal. Most entrepreneurs don't know how to design a profitable business model. So they don't have a clarity of what business model is profitable. They just go with the flow and they say there's too much competition, margins are reducing. So I said, performance acceleration is a result of not just competence enhancement, but also of clarity enhancement. You need to be clear about your goals. You need to be clear about your business model. You need to be clear about your systems. You need to be clear about the roles of your team members. Says, hey, this makes sense. So if entrepreneurs started enhancing their clarity and then growing the skills and knowledge of themselves and their team members, automatically performance will accelerate. And then through the interviews, I looked at another aspect, and another aspect stood out, saying that there are certain organizations where there is great amount of clarity. People know what needs to be done, how it needs to be done. There's amazing levels of capability, but people are still not delivering the result. And when I probed further, I realized that even after having clarity, even after having capabilities, if people are not delivering the result, it's because they're not aligned to the culture. There's probably too much blame game, ego, politics, groupism, favoritism that is happening at the workplace, which is not making people apply their capability in the areas where they have clarity. So I said, hey, performance acceleration is actually a result of clarity enhancement, capability enhancement or competence enhancement, and culture enhancement. So all of this started falling in place for me personally as an entrepreneur, and I started implementing this within my own business. It made a tremendous difference. 2014, when I started this interviewing journey, to 2016, when I actually published the book Lead or Bleed, I put a small summary of this, of the PACE system in my book Lead or Bleed. And PACE then stood for PA is performance acceleration, is a result of, is the support line. CE is clarity, competence, culture, and E is enhancement. So if you want to accelerate performance of your business, of your department, of your team member, then you need to enhance the clarity, the competence, and the culture of your business, of yourself, and of your team members. So that became like the theory. And then I broke down the philosophy into steps. So I put 5 stages, that there has to be, how do you set goals, and how do you analyze the gaps, and then how you have awareness of clarity, competence, and culture, and then how you create an action plan, and then how do you achieve those goals through a clear review system. So PACE actually has 5 stages: aspiration, analysis, awareness, action planning, and achievement. So I put tools, frameworks, made it a step-by-step system, made it a 10-step system where people could take steps one step at a time, not spending more than 2 hours on a step. And I started teaching it to businesses that were pretty close to me at a one-to-one level with a few friends. Feb 2016, I published my book, Lead or Bleed. First 80 pages of that 280-page book was the pay system in summary. And I was expecting my family and friends to buy the book. None of them bought the book. They wanted it for free. They wanted Xerox copies of it. And something crazy happened. Within 2 weeks, the book went on to be a bestseller because I started getting a lot of media attention saying there were 300 interviews this guy did for this book. So let's ask the author, which was his favorite interview? Which leader's philosophy did he resonate with the most? So I got quite a bit of good PR and media coverage. The book started getting picked up by people. Within 6 months, we sold close to 14,000 copies and I was like, wow, I didn't even expect this to happen. I'll be honest with you, ladies and gentlemen. 2012 was a very difficult year in my life. I had two other businesses, a recruitment business and a project management outsourcing business, which we shut down. I was in a 70 lakh loss of 45 lakh rupee debt. And the biggest goal of my life at that point of time as an entrepreneur in 2012 was, if I can make 60,000 rupees and take it home, I could provide for my family. That was my biggest goal. I would be a liar if I spoke to all of you on this video and said, I visualized this, that I'll build a consulting company. I visualized this, that I would speak on international stages with gurus that I admire. I would be a liar if I said that. And I just went with the flow. I just did what was right. I just looked at learning and taking responsibility for my business rather than blaming circumstance, life, luck, chance, fate, karma, and all of those kind of things. And the book was a reward of the universe. I was like, wow, I didn't expect the book to do this. I mean, who knew Rajiv Talreja? Who cares who Rajiv Talreja was? The book went and became crazily huge. A lot of entrepreneurs started reaching out saying, hey, we'd like to learn the pay system from you. And April 2016, I think it was 24, 25, 26th of April 2016, where I did my first ever business space program with 31 entrepreneurs in the Park Hotel in Bangalore, where we provided lunch and dinner for 3 days because it's a program that we used to do from 9 in the morning to 9 in the night. These 31 entrepreneurs were largely friends from my BNI chapter, and I'm ever so grateful to them because they had their faith in me. We started the first space program in 2016. Success Gyan's CEO Suren was there in the program as an observer, and I had invited him because I was a student of Success Gyan programs. And those of you who don't know Success Gyan, it's India's largest seminar organizing company. They brought people like Robert Kiyosaki, Brian Tracy, T. Harv Eker, Les Brown, all these legendary gurus and speakers to India. So I was a student attending Success Gyan programs from 2014 to 2016. So I invited Suren saying, Suren, I have bought every single program of yours and I bought the coaching packages of every single speaker that you brought to the country. I'm doing my first program. Can you come and observe and give me feedback? At the end of 3 days, Suren took me out to the balcony of that banquet room in Park Hotel. And he said, what the hell was that? I was like, what happened? He's like, I have never ever seen someone develop a system which is so precise, which is so accurate, deals with everyday problems of entrepreneurs, and is you've simplified how to implement these steps that you've created. And look at the audience, they are blown. He's like, Rajiv, I've built Success Gyan from 2012 till now. Over the last 4 years, brought more than 50 international speakers and trainers to India. And people often come and ask me, why don't you have an Indian trainer who Success Gyan is promoting their programs of? And he's like, I didn't find one. And he said, but I believe by seeing what I've seen in the last 3 days, I think I found my first Indian trainer. And he looked at me and said, Rajiv, will you be the first Indian trainer whose program Success Gyan will promote? Now, here was an organization who used to host all international speakers. And I was a student in their programs. Here is the best in the business. They would do 100-150 events in a year, more than 1 lakh participants attending their events. And they are telling me, we want to promote your program. for me, that was like heaven's doors opening. And I cried that night to my wife. I cried because my expectation in life was 60,000 rupees a month. If I'm able to do that, ghar chal jayega. And when this happened, I was like, wow. You know, when I was in debt in 2012, I spent 2 years of my life chasing money, chasing opportunities. Nothing worked. And in 2014, when I made a decision saying it's not about chasing money, but it's about becoming more capable, and I committed myself to learning, I took chances. I borrowed money to invest in training and coaching for myself. And I went on this research journey, and I studiously interviewed 300 entrepreneurs, not knowing what it's going to give me, just for my learning. And the universe suddenly became so kind. And this is where a very strong belief got ingrained, that when you do something, when you do the right thing with the right reason and the right intention, the universe has your back and it gives you way more than what you have ever desired. Today, as I'm making this video and I'm talking to you about the 50th PACE program, and I look back, I'm like, wow, I never ever imagined that this would happen. I never imagined that we would be working out of 11,000 square feet office with a 40 member team. I never imagined that. I never imagined that I would have the privilege and honor to represent India and go speak at stages internationally with people like Gary Vaynerchuk or Grant Cardone or John D. Martini or Jack Canfield. For me, these people were iconic. And that's what PACE has done. April 2016, I did the first PACE program. Suren made the offer to me. He called me back the next day and he said, Rajiv, I was just thinking, the participants who were there at this program were more of your immediate friends who are entrepreneurs. Before Success Yaan starts promoting PACE, I think I would want to see you do one more PACE program with an audience that is unknown. So go out and promote it and get another bunch of audience, and I'd like to see the feedback from them. So he kind of took me 30,000 feet high on that Sunday night, and Monday he threw me back on the floor saying, gravity is testing you, son. And I said, fair enough, Suren. June, we put together another batches, and I remember I used to make calls personally. Me, Karan Pranav used to make calls personally to entrepreneurs saying, hey, we have this 3-day program, please come and attend it, give it a shot. And by doing all the groundwork and effort ourselves, we could get another 48 participants for the next one in June. Suren saw the results of that program. He saw the feedback of the entrepreneurs, the kind of business growth that they were experiencing after implementing the PACE system. And he said, okay, 31st of July, Success Gyan is doing a big event called National Achievers Conference in Bangalore. Bangalore is your hometown. There is Dr. John D. Martini, who's read 30,000 books. He's featured in the movie Secret. He's probably one of the most wisest men on the planet. He's the key speaker. We have a property millionaire from London called Kevin Green. He's going to be another speaker. We have Courtney Smith, who's a stock marketing trader, who's a history making stock marketing trader. He's going to be another speaker. I have one slot and I'm willing to take a chance on you. Are you ready to take that chance on yourself? And he said, you have only one shot. If the audience does not resonate with your content, if the feedback from the audience is not that great, it'll be the last time that Success Gyan and Success Resources will promote you. I said, done. Let's do it. And it was my hometown. I walked into the National Achievers Conference event here in Bangalore. It was happening in a place called Manyata Tech Park. They have a huge convention center there. And the first thing I saw was my picture next to all these legends. I was like, wow, this is way beyond what I thought. And I go in, I go backstage. I was nervous, my palms were sweating. I delivered my keynote. I invited the audience to register for the PACE program from there. And I ended up with the highest number of sales that day. And I was like, oh, what a relief. And that's how my journey of doing PACE programs at Success Gyan started. We then took it to Chennai, then we took it to Mumbai, we took it to Delhi, we took it to Hyderabad, we took it to Ahmedabad, we did one in Kolkata. And then in 2018, I did it in Philippines, and then we did one in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia, then we did in Sri Lanka and Colombo. And over these last 4 years, all I can say is the universe has been kind. We've had more than 6,000 entrepreneurs who've gone through the PACE program. Each and every one of them vouches for the impact it has had on their lives. And now when the 50th one is coming, and I sit here doing this video, randomly sharing everything with all of you, I'm like, wow, this was beyond my dreams. So my question is, I don't know, was it my destiny? And my spiritual mentor, Sidra, right on the first PACE program that I did, I remember on the Saturday afternoon, she called Suren. She was talking to Suren about something, and she told Suren, you're at Rajiv's program. He said, yes. And she said, just tell him, he's finally doing what he's meant to do. And that day I knew that this was a message. This was a message from above that this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. So when this 50th one is approaching, I'm just walking into this 50th PACE program with a lot of nostalgia, with a lot of gratitude, knowing that this is just the 50th. Probably do this for the rest of my life. That's pretty much what I wanted to share with you guys. The journey of how PACE evolved. The journey of how I was just doing what I felt was right at every single step. And all those steps led to this point. So I don't know if it is a dream coming true. I don't know if it is destiny. I leave it up to you to decide that. But I also invite you as an entrepreneur to do the right thing with the right reason, with the right intention, and surrender yourself to the universe, because the universe definitely has your back. It took 10 years for me to realize that and start doing the right things, another 2 years of hard work from there, and then the universe has been supportive since then, and it has blessed me with the opportunity to serve entrepreneurs who've gone on to build meaningful, profitable, purpose-driven, people-centric businesses. Because that's what the mission of PACE is. It is to help entrepreneurs build a business which works without them. It's to help entrepreneurs build a business where they add massive value to their clients. And because they add massive value to their clients, their business grows. And because their business grows, they can give that financial growth and career growth to their team members and can enjoy the financial growth and brand growth for themselves as an entrepreneur. So if you ask me what's PACE, it's a system to set, track and achieve goals in every department of your business in a win-win-win manner, where your customer wins, your team wins, you win, and it's a step-by-step proven formula. My dream for this system is for it to become like a standard management practice, a way of working for organizations. That's what keeps me up at night. I want to give PACE back to the planet as my legacy. Like how people talk about Six Sigma, like how people talk about lean manufacturing and Kaizen and all these methodologies. I need your blessings that one day people talk about PACE, that are you using the PACE system? And I'm going to dedicate every single minute and moment of my life for the rest of my life to serve entrepreneurs using this system. Till it becomes a norm where entrepreneurs ask each other, PACE kiya hai, nahi kiya hai, karna zaruri hai. So yeah, that were my thoughts, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening. Tell me what you take out of these reflection videos, these random conversations with me. I hope something opened up for you, and I hope something was of value to you. Tell me in the comments. See you guys in my next reflection video.